The Mariana Trench is the deepest natural trench in the world, located in the western Pacific Ocean around 200 kilometers east of the Mariana Islands. Its maximum known depth is 10,984 meters, but some measurements put its deepest point at 11,034 meters. That is deep, bruh. So deep that if you stuck Mount Everest inside of it, the tip of the mountain would still be 2 kilometers underwater. We don't know a whole lot about what lies inside the Mariana Trench, but what if we somehow drained it? What exactly would we find? That is the question we are asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life, and occasionally we answer them too. If you're lucky. I'm Charlotte Dobre, and thanks for clicking on this video. Subscribe for more daily head scratchers and follow the creative team behind LBQ on social media. The Mariana Trench is the deepest natural trench in the world, and hardly any light reaches the deepest points. There's also a tremendous amount of pressure at the bottom. The water column above exerts a pressure of 1,086 bars, which is 1,000 times the standard atmospheric pressure at sea level. To put it into perspective, it would be like having an African elephant stand on your big toenail. Ouch. Yet somehow, life still exists within the Mariana Trench. Xenophyrophores have been found inside the trench by the Scripps Institution of Oceanography at a record depth of 10.6 kilometers below the sea surface. First discovered in 1883 by Henry Bowman Brady, xenophyrophores are unicellular organisms found on the ocean floor. They extract minerals from their surroundings and use them to form an exoskeleton. According to data, microbial life does exist within the trench. Not only that, it thrives. 80% of life on our planet lives in the deep ocean under conditions that are completely unfathomable to us. At the same time, there would likely be piles of whale and shark carcasses being fed on by deep sea creatures at the bottom of the trench. There are also larger creatures in the trench, observed during a 1960s descent. Flatfish and shrimp, according to Picard, who also said, I quote, "The bottom appeared light and clear, a waste of firm diatomaceous ooze." Other scientists are skeptical of Picard's observations and suggest he might have actually seen a sea cucumber. In December of 2014, a new species of snailfish was found at the depth of 8,145 meters, in addition to giant crustaceans. These organisms are able to grow quite large due to a process known as deep sea gigantism. The point is, if we drain the Mariana Trench, we would probably find a plethora of undiscovered species that we never knew existed because the trench is so inaccessible to humans. But life isn't all you will find in the Mariana Trench. The effect of humans, pollution, and waste are seen even at the deepest, most inaccessible parts of the ocean. During Victor Vescovos' record-breaking dive in 2014, he reported seeing a plastic bag as well as candy wrappers in the trench. Research has also shown that amphipods that were found in the trench ingest microplastics, and 100% of them were found to have eaten at least one piece of synthetic material. To make matters even worse, Scientific American reported that tests found the presence of carbon-14 inside the body of aquatic animals. Carbon-14 is from nuclear bomb testing. Contrary to popular belief, the trench is not the part of the seafloor that's closest to the center of the Earth. You won't find liquid magma at the bottom. This is because the Earth is an oblate spheroid, not a perfect sphere. But at the bottom of the trench, there is something going on called tectonic plate subduction. It's actually been proposed that the Mariana Trench could be a place where humans could dispose of nuclear waste, in the hopes that the waste might be pushed down into the Earth's mantle. But as nuclear waste dumping is prohibited by international law, that just isn't an option. Another interesting fact, plate subduction zones are known to be associated with megathrust earthquakes. They are very sensitive areas, and it's definitely not a good idea to disrupt this ecosystem in any way. We don't know a whole lot about what happens in the Mariana Trench, what kind of life exists, what the geology is like. It would be a very interesting feat to drain the trench and find out exactly what the most mysterious part of the ocean holds. Alas, we can't drain the trench, and maybe that's a good thing. If we drained it, all the aquatic life, all the undiscovered species within the trench would die. And at the same time, if we disrupt this delicate balance by draining the trench and removing the immense pressure of the water above, this delicate ecosystem might be disrupted, and megathrust earthquakes could occur, shaking the Earth's mantle. What do you think would happen if we drained the Mariana Trench? What would we find? Let us know in the comments. For now, I'm gonna take a moment to answer some comments and questions from my last video on this channel. What if you fell into liquid nitrogen? Potato Mato said, "You will become the rapper Ice Cube." True. Austin said, "What if you were to drink liquid nitrogen?" Short answer, you would die. All in Your Head Production said, "If Pinocchio said his nose was gonna grow, would it grow? And if it does that mean he'd be lying? I don't know, it keeps me up at night." I would imagine that if Pinocchio said his nose would grow, it wouldn't grow, because that's not a lie. Pinocchio is known for lying, and when he does, his nose grows. Okay, I'm confused. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to keep watching, check out the playlist that's currently flashing on your screen. And don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications, and I will see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.